Good morning, welcome to the Congregational Church of Dunbarton. I was expecting like two people. It's a Sunday after Christmas, well we had Sunday last Sunday, but Sunday after Christmas is always a low Sunday, but it's great to see so many people here. I promise to make more bulletins next Sunday. With your friends. Really enjoys this week.
Sure, let's do 1, 2, and 5.
accept you, ruler of peace. We wage war on the most vulnerable, and in ourselves we wage war on vulnerability itself.
God's our King, God's own people,
and the people do not accept the world.
We do not accept you, light of the world. We block your shining, light shining within us, putting barriers between us. Sexism, racism, heterosexism, cissexism, ableism, ageism. We are caught in systems beyond our control. Holy Word of God, call us to yourselves once again. And hear these words in the Gospel according to John. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen the Word's glory. Glory as of a parent's only child, full of grace and truth. From this fullness we have received, all received, grace upon grace. Our forgiveness is assured as God's mercies, which abound endlessly. Amen.
First reading is from the first chapter of Ephesians. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but God, the one and only, who is at the Father's side, has made him known. That's the end of today's reading.
last year, and 15.2% positivity rate in New Hampshire.
summer was pretty good overall. We started to meet in person as a church again. But in the fall, we saw fighting for masks or no masks in school. The supply chain got really messed up and, of course, inflation. Are things better in January 2021 or in January 2022? There are probably some things that are better now, and in some ways, things are not. Our passage from this week contains hope. The Word was with God, the Word was God. John came to prepare the way of Jesus, and then Jesus came. God came to earth, but the world didn't recognize God. A lot of times over this past year, maybe we have had a hard time discerning the presence of God in our lives and in our world. Even though we know that Jesus with us in the midst of so much death, so much sorrow, so much anger and division, where is Jesus to be found? We can't see him as large, as plain, as unmistakable to our eyes of faith as maybe we should. John reminds us that it is not, that it has always been so, that Christ is present. After all, the gospel tells us that Jesus came that which was his own, but his own did not recognize him. The long-awaited one was here, and the people just missed him. The text of John 1:10 confronts us and forces us to ask ourselves, yes, perhaps we saw Jesus, but we didn't recognize him. Did we take his incarnation into our time and space seriously enough to realize that this changes everything? And maybe if we did not take it seriously, or if we did take it more seriously, more would change. Improvement might begin to happen more. John also refers to Jesus as the light. Just after we realized that this pandemic was not going to be over in the 10 days we thought it would, back in March of 2020. Remember those days? My wife and I rearranged our basement. It started with just a little portable table in front of our sofa, and a shower curtain behind me to hide the rest of our messy basement. I have two little cellar windows, which just look out into window wells. It's got covered up with snow as winter came, so there was no natural light down there. At least in the spring, summer, and fall, there's a teeny amount. But I found without natural light, my body does not realize what time it is. I have a hard time getting my brain moving in the morning, and then we'll be wide awake at night, or really awake in the morning and productive, and then by 3 o'clock in the afternoon, I feel like it's bedtime. These past months have made me realize how important light is. But we also have the ability to create light. In my corner of the basement I set up right now, I have lights that help me see, lights that help me look brighter when I do video stuff, where I need to be lit up. Like most things, light is not always great. With a cat, a dog, and one son still living at home, it's hard to keep our home clean and looking okay. When evening comes, the shades are drawn, the lights are low, the house looks fine. But in the morning, we open up the shades, let the light in, notice that the windows really need to be washed. The rug needs to be vacuumed. There's a toy or a piece of a game that somehow ended up in the middle of the floor. There's cat and dog here on the furniture. There's often a way in which we describe problems in our community. We shine a light on the issue. The problem has come to light. And usually this is good. We want problems to come to light. But it does make us have to deal with those problems. During this time with the children, I talked about resolutions. Yes, it is January 2nd, but you can still make a resolution. And I'd like to challenge you this morning to think about something in your life you'd like to bring to light this year. Maybe this is good, or maybe this is something that you want to work on. Maybe this is a change that you have made that you want to share, or maybe it's something that you want to change but haven't gotten to yet. By bringing it into the light, you can clearly see what needs to be done, what that change might mean for you, and what the steps are that might be needed to make that change. And also think too often in my life, and probably many of our lives, we separate our lives into our personal lives and our church lives as if they were two separate things. But in John's passage this morning, we hear again that God is always with us in our church lives and in our personal lives. We may not be that excited about this year. Personally, I had more hope for change last year than I do this year. But I still hold out hope. Even though God was not recognized 2,000 years ago, maybe this year will be different. Maybe in some of the changes that I hope to make this year, I can involve God where I may not have consciously done that before. I want to make just a short reflection this morning and take a few minutes to think about what you might want to shine your light on this year. And while we're doing that, we can put on hymn 584. Hey, Bob? Bob. We're going to play hymn 584, which probably is on the thumb drive. Because I don't think I would transfer that over. 584. Is it on the thumb drive? Keeping my fingers crossed. Thank you.
Please continue to pray for Mom's brother Art in Maine. He's doing well, and we are giving really mighty prayers of thanks to God for his wonderful caregivers and his caregivers who are with him the whole day. He's only alone in the evening. And those caregivers have, you know, just the stimulation of having somebody in his home talking with him all day long is made him into a happy person.
We'll keep on in our prayers. Still my friend Rhoda Carr, Bach, she is still fighting with her cancer and her other problems. And she's taking treatment, she's doing okay, but things are slow. We'll keep on in our prayers. Join me in spirit of prayer. God of life, God of new life, by the birth of Jesus, you have brought light into our darkness. Shine in our lives, Christ Jesus, by your coming, and set us free from ministry. God of life, God of new life, nothing will separate us from your love. Give us the faith to trust your promise. Christ Jesus, by your coming, set us free from ministry. God of life, God of new life, you call us to serve the hungry, the poor, the lonely, the outcast. Show us how we can respond. Christ Jesus, by your coming, set us free from ministry. God of life, God of new life, Jesus was born in poverty and lived under oppression. Open our eyes to injustice and inspire us to proclaim your reign. Christ Jesus, by your coming, set us free from ministry. God of life, God of new life, by the birth of Jesus, bring healing to those in need, especially those we need before you now in this moment of silence. Your coming set us free from ministry. God of life, God of new life, inspire this congregation to reach out beyond its walls, beyond our fears, beyond our past. Help us to welcome your future. Jesus Christ, by your coming, set us free from ministry. God of life, God of new life, by the birth of Jesus, you have brought light into our darkness. Shine in our lives and set us free from ministry. We pray this in the name of Jesus, our light, our life, and our hope. Amen. Many people have been sending in their offerings or dropping them in the basket in the back of the church, and I'd like to take a moment to dedicate those offerings. Would you please join me in our prayer dedication found in your bulletin? Most wise and wondrous God, we pray that soon, very soon, your blessings will cover the face of the earth like a mist, that divine offerings and the offerings of human hands mingle imperceptibly as every need is satisfied. Amen. Luke the Evangelist wrote about the risen Savior, who at the table with two disciples took bread, blessed it, broke it, and gave it to him. And their eyes were opened, and they recognized the risen Christ in the breaking of the bread. In company with all believers at every time and beyond time, we come to this table to know the risen Christ in the breaking of the bread. Our communion table is open to all who seek to know Christ in their lives. So all are welcome at this table, regardless of age or gender or anything, any divisions that we may create in our human lives, and everybody is welcome at this table. Would you please join me in our communion hymn number 330, let us break the bread together. Number 330. Yeah.
Through your love for the world, the Word became flesh and lived among us, full of grace and truth. The angels herald glory to you in the highest heavens and peace to all people on earth. And we join with them, with all people, to praise your holy name. Holy Lord, God of endless love, earth and heaven are surely full of your glory. The angels sang of it, we've been lavished with it. Blessed is he who is born that we might have life. Glory to God on earth, and God be upon glory on earth and peace to all people. Holy God, as the travelers traveled with their treasures, were overwhelmed with joy of finding Jesus, so we are overwhelmed by finding out the depth of his love for us. For Jesus showed us how beloved we are to him by loving us and giving himself for us. On that night he gave himself up for us. He sat at the table and he broke bread with his friends and he said, "Take and eat. This is my body which is broken for you. Remember this each time you do it." After they had eaten, he took the cup, and he said, "Remember me as you drink from this every time, for this is my life, poured out for you, the beginning of a new relationship with God. Send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts of bread and wine, O God, that we may experience the presence of the Word made flesh in Jesus Christ. Breathe your Spirit into us, that we may be one body with him, living out his ministry in the world today and every day. We pray this all in Jesus' name." These are the gifts of God for people of God. And we only have one. No, we've got a few of the hard ones, the single cups. If you have little fingers and not feeling adventurous, the chalices are easier to open. Just about the people of God.
your table and granting us the presence of Christ. Strengthen our faith, increase our love for one another, and send us forth into the world in courage and peace, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Does anybody have a Christmas carol for our closing song today? More upbeat than the last one.
Really by next Sunday, but somewhere around there would be great.